Dear students and friends, I am Professor N.K. Chadha, former professor head, psychology department of University of Delhi. In continuing to my earlier videos related to the examination anxiety, today I will be talking about examination anxiety and the questions which often I get from the students. In last 40 years as a psychologist, the questions which often imposed to me by students, which are very genuine and thought-provoking questions, I will share one by one some of the important questions and then try to answer it to help you to overcome your exam anxiety. One question which is often asked by students, that does eating chocolate reduce anxiety? It's a good question, and my answer simple to that is yes. Not only chocolate, yes, black chocolate helped you reducing your anxiety related to exams, but it's not only the chocolates, even the chewing gum, the cookies, the other sweets can also reduce. But other sweet, I know, means you take in large quantity. Other sweets basically will help you reducing anxiety, but chocolates definitely will much more helpful. Another question asked by students, that sitting in the examination hall, all my other friends, what I see around me, are writing very fast, the answer to the question, and I am a slow writer, how can I reduce my exam anxiety? Listen, my answer to this is you and they are they. Don't try to compare with them. Try to understand your own potential. Don't follow what they are doing it. You continue with your speed, with accuracy. If you keep thinking that they are right, fast writer than you, then my dear students, this will increase your exam anxiety. Take out this thought from your mind. The another question which asked by the student often is that I could not prepare for my test properly. How can I reduce my anxiety in that case when I'm not prepared? My answer, have deep breath. Take a deep breath. And whatever time you have at your disposal, instead of thinking on that you could not prepare, you utilize that time in going through the syllabus. It might be a little faster, but it will help you to overcome your anxiety. Another question, it's a very interesting question which asked by student, that is it bad to study overnight? I study entire night, is it bad? My answer, yes, definitely bad. If you could not take your proper sleep which is required for the body. Body requires some amount of sleep, and that you must have. And don't study entire night. Plan, organize your night sleep, have deep sleep, maybe 4 hours, and then start preparing fresh. This will make your preparation much more better. It's a good, interesting question. Another interesting question which often I get from people is that, should I avoid consuming caffeine? Because I feel so stressed out that I feel like going for it. There's a craving coming to me. My answer, in short, definitely you avoid caffeine. Caffeine will increase or raise your level of anxiety and definitely related to your examination which you are going to have it. So kindly reduce that. Another question which often asked by student, that last time I missed by 40 marks or 30 marks and that is still on my mind. How I can reduce in that case? I may this year again lose 5 marks. So my answer, if you keep on thinking on that, then this will not allow your mind to get free to prepare. Forget what happened, start your journey new. If you keep on thinking and spending your energy and time, energy spent somewhere which is not utilized in your life, utilize energy which is more fruitful and meaningful for you. Another question, I have not studied properly for my exams. If that's true with me, then how I can lessen my anxiety related to exam when I'm not prepared? Do you think still you have a time? Think over. If yes, if you still have a time, then utilize in preparing rather than thinking that you could not prepare your exams. Go through the syllabus quickly, scan it, and that paper is not the end of the world. That is one paper, one exam, the others also. So if you lose something over here, then you can compensate by concentrating on other exams. So remember that you have to compete. And that confidence, self-confidence, which I've told you in my earlier slide, earlier video also, please keep on in your mind. That will help you, that will strengthen you to overcome your examination anxiety. Another very interesting question. I do not do well on my first examination, which I given the other day. How can I concentrate on studying for my next examination when I'm anxious and afraid? Who made you anxious and afraid? My answer is you yourself. You could not do in the last examination. You think you could not do well. Fine. Can you do anything for that? You can't do. Whatever had happened, had happened. Now you have to think with future orientation. The next examination comes. I can't do anything what has happened, but I can definitely think. I can definitely do far better in the next that might compensate what I couldn't do in the past. So there your focus should be future oriented rather than to the past what had already happened. Happened means happened. Another question, very interesting, asked by students often that, what if I'm missing 1/3 of the information I need to know? I got only 1/3 of the information. That 33% of the information I have, and 2/3 of the information I don't have. The information which you don't have, you can't do it. But strengthen yourself on the information that is 66% or 2/3 of the information which you have. In cash on that information rather than struggling but you don't have. If you can dig out that information, or maybe there's the likelihood that when you make yourself very good in the 2/3 of the information which you have, then 1/3 will also might come in your rescue. The information you got from 2/3 can help in answering some of the, or maybe related with some of the information which you don't have at this moment, rather than just struggling what you don't have. Another question, interesting. Even if I prepare well, anxiety pressure me a lot. What can I do? Though I prepared very well. If you prepared very well, then I don't see the reason why you think you can't do. If you practice it, planned it, time management you have done it with your work, obviously this will help you to overcome. Take deep breath, relax, change your posture. Maybe you have a sip of water, you know. Maybe you can have a small cup of soft drink. Maybe you can have a chocolate, which I told you. Change your mindset and start working fresh. This will help you to overcome. Is some fear of an exam anxiety is very common? Here, the answer in your question, yes, it's a very common phenomenon. Everyone undergo exam anxiety. It's not you are the different person. You think it's you. No. Every one of us, including me, I also experienced in my career the examination anxiety. It's a normal phenomenon. It's a common to everyone. Why we should fear of that? Why are we bringing that fear on mind? Let's take out the fear from the mind. Another question. How do I deal with anxiety when I'm running out of time? Try to stop at least for a few seconds and think, are you sure running out of the time? Or using this as a defense mechanism, you're running out of the time. You have to catch it, not to bring any negative thought in your mind. It's you who brought the thought that you're running out of time, and you keep on struggling with that thought, I'm sorry, you will run out of time. Catch the time. Time is in front of you. Avoid as much as possible self-sabotage. You're doing a self-sabotage by saying you run out of the time. Why? I feel so anxious to compare myself with others, because you are not governed by your own internal consciousness. Make your internal consciousness stronger. And when you make it stronger, what I want to say, think, if you whatever you achieve, what efforts you put on that. Whatever you could not achieve till now, where you lack. Once you identify that, where you lack, I'm sure you can overcome that. These are the few questions which I thought to share with you, which I have often get through from my clients. Whenever a child come, whenever the parents come with the child, or whenever I hold any kind of training session, I find students, the children's really ask. I hope, I wish these questions and the answers will be helpful to you to overcome your examination anxiety. Good luck. Thank you.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.